everyone, I'm Claudine Roselle Puente, and some of you know me as Lady Saiyan. And today I am going to show you how to make takoyaki using the perfect puff. Now, this product is very similar to the pancake puff. I don't know if you've seen that infomercial, and this has actually worked. I did my first attempt of making takoyaki using this, and it turned out to be a really, really good success. So I'm going to give this a go again and show you exactly how it can be done. Now, first things first, before you make takoyaki, you are going to need your ingredients. You're going to need your 1 2/3 cups of flour. You're also going to need your 2 1/2 cup of dashi soup. Now, I like this one better. I've tried other dashi soups, but this one is definitely superb to making takoyaki. You are also going to need your 2 eggs. You're going to need your 1/2 pound of boiled octopus. And this time I got cooked octopus, unlike the taco sashimi. And I mean, although that one's good, it does take a while to cook, but I prefer to get the cooked one already. And you're also going to need your 1/4 cup of green onions chopped, followed by 1/4 cup of cooked shrimp. Now, some people prefer just the octopus in their takoyaki. I like to put shrimp because it gives it a little bit more flavor. So if you want to use the shrimp, that's fine. And if you don't want to use it, that's fine also. You're also going to need your 1/4 cup of red pickled ginger. And then for your toppings, you're going to need your bottle of Worcestershire sauce, followed by mayonnaise. Now, some people, I don't know where they get this idea that they have to go to the Japanese supermarket and get that mayo. I mean, if you're happy with this mayonnaise or Miracle Whip or any other type of mayonnaise, that's fine also. I mean, you don't have to go out of your way and just get something just for specifically for this, because even this mayonnaise is just as good. And last but not least, you can also top it off with the aonori, which is the sprinkled seaweed, and that goes on for topping. Now, I notice I did not bring up the bonito flakes. I'm not going to use bonito flakes. Some people don't like bonito flakes, and unfortunately, I'm one of them. So we're going to have to do without that. But I will definitely show you that this is definitely a good dish, and I hope you enjoy. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to start off with the water. So we're going to boil that for our dashi soup, and then you see how it goes.
While our water is boiling, we're going to start by chopping up our ingredients. We're going to start out with our green onions, and all you need is 1/4 cup of green onions. You don't need a whole lot. So what we're going to do is we're going to take off the little head like so.
As you can see, I'm finely cutting them. You don't want to make them too big. You want to make them as fine as you can, just as fine as possible.
Next up, what we're going to do is we are going to chop our shrimp. And with the shrimp, you want to cut them into bite-sized pieces. You don't want them very, very thick. You want to make sure that they are just right just for your takoyaki balls. Okay. And from there, you are going to use your octopus, like so. And you just cut like this.
Okay. Now with the octopus, you just want bite-sized parts. You don't want anything huge, just something that will fit in your mouth.
Okay. Now once we're done with that, I think our water has just boiled. So I'm going to go and get that, and I will be right back with the dashi soup. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 1 teaspoon of the dashi soup, and then that's all you need. All you need is just 1 teaspoon. And then I'm going to put 2 1/2 cups of the water. So we'll start off with that. Now I'm going to put in the eggs. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with this. And then we've got one egg there. And then what you're going to do is you're going to mix it gently. So I got one egg, and then I'll slowly put the other.
Okay, and then from this point, what we're going to do is we are going to take our flour, and all we need is just 1 2/3 cups of that flour.
Okay, now from here, what I do is I don't take a heaping cup of it. I just do the exact one, and I just skim it right off, like so. You want to keep it as straight as possible. You want to keep it like so. And then when you sprinkle it, you want to go little by little. You don't want to plop it all the way in. Just do little by little, bit by bit.
Okay, so we're going to do little, like so. Okay, now when you see your batter, it doesn't really come out thick, and it's not supposed to be too thick. You don't want it too thick. If it's too thick, then it doesn't cook properly, and sometimes you end up getting a lot of huge clumps. So what you want to do is, as you mix, get rid of as many clumps as you can from the flour. Then you've got your thing.
Okay, now once your batter is mixed, you are ready to go ahead and start making your takoyaki. And I will take you straight to the stove right now.
Okay, now that we're over here at the stove, I'm going to show you the perfect puff. And it comes with a couple of items. It comes with the flipping sticks, which is right here. It comes with the sugar shaker, I haven't put that out, and the pastry filler. Now, for takoyaki, you only need 2 of the components from that perfect puff. You need your mixing sticks, and you need your pastry filler. And one more component I forgot to mention in terms of cooking. You're going to need your Pam. Pam is your friend. I don't know what anybody has mentioned, but anytime somebody usually would say, oh, just put oil and then that's better. Sometimes some oils have a lot of fat. They've got cholesterol. They've got, you know, all that stuff. But if you want something like really healthy, yeah, just stick to the Pam. The Pam is much better. Okay. Now from here, what I'm going to do is I'm only going to take 2 bite-sized pieces of the octopus and I'm going to put it into one of the cups. Now for the shrimp, I can just take like a few bits here. And like I said, you know, if you don't want shrimp in it, it's okay. You don't have to put shrimp in your stuff. So if you just want it regularly like this, then that's fine. And then what we can do is we can just put it in like so. So again, just 2 bite-sized pieces of the octopus and just put them right into the cups, like so. And then you have your little bits of shrimp here, and then you put the rest of it in here like so. Okay, then what you're going to need is you're going to take your a little bit of onion and you're going to dash it right in the middle of each cup here. So just don't put too much. You don't want too much onion. Some people don't like that many onions, and that's fine. I'd say about a thumb size of the onions, or like about this much in quantity. Just put them in the cuts. Just